Data sorting allows you to sort data based on multiple cells and in ascending or descending order. In this segment, you'll learn how to find and activate the feature, use the feature to sort data, and how to develop customized sort orders. In this example, you have a list of cities, salespeople in those cities, the products they sold, and their sales total. You'd like to sort it in various ways. To perform a sort, you highlight all the cells that you want sorted. You click Data and then Sort, and this will pop up. And what it asks you is, what must it sort by and which way must it go, ascending or descending? And you'll see here that my list has, and in this case, it's automatically guessed that there's a header row here. You could say no header row, and you'll see that it tries to sort everything. And in this case, this line here would also be mixed up. If you click header row, it realizes that is a header row. It'll only sort these out. So for example, we can sort by, let's say, city, and we want it to go in ascending order. If we click OK, you'll see that all this data is sorted in alphabetical order. It is important to note that when you highlight the cells, you must highlight all the cells you want sorted. So for example, if we only highlighted that section and we said data sort, and this time we work on salesperson in ascending order, if you watch this first row here, you'll see that this is Johannesburg, Trevor, standard product for 4,000. When we click OK, you'll see that although the sales have stayed the same, the information has moved around and they are no longer in the correct rows. So if we undo, you must remember to highlight the entire section before you sort. You can also perform multiple sorts. So we've highlighted our cells. If we go to data sort, you can say, well, I first want to sort by, let's say, sales, and I want it to be in descending order. And then I want to sort by the salesperson in ascending alphabetical order, and then maybe by the city, again in ascending order. And if we click OK, you'll see that it's listed now first by sales, then by the salesperson's name, if there's a tie, and then by the city. If we go back to the sort box, you may have noticed that there's an options button here. If you click it, you'll see that you can set the first key sort order to be normal, but if you click on it, there's a whole bunch of other possible orders. So in this case, there's days of the week, months, etc. And using this feature, you can set up to have a personalized sort order. So for example, how would you do this if instead of being in alphabetical order, what you'd like to have is, let's say, New York, then London, then Johannesburg, then Paris. To customize the sort order, cancel this and go to Tools, Options, and you'll see there's a tab here called Custom Lists. If you click on it, you'll see all those lists we showed there. And what you can now do is add your own personalized list. You can now add your own customized list. Click in the list entries and type the order you want it to be in. So we said we first want New York, then London, then Johannesburg, and then Paris. If you click Add, you'll see your list now appears here. If we say OK, we highlight the cells again and say data sort. Now let's make that city, remove that one, remove that one. We'll make it ascending for the city and we'll say options. And when you click in here and go to the bottom, you'll see that our list is now there. We'll click on that list, say OK. And if you watch here, when you click OK, you'll see that our new order has come in. It is not alphabetical, it is the order we have recommended: New York, London, Johannesburg, Paris.